I need more crack oil. So, welcome back, fellow acolytes, ladies, gentlemen, and Factorio-interested people. We are back with another episode. Am I recording? Yeah. Of Factorio. And last time we finished off. Let's see. Let's do stack inserters. We finished off producing enough solar energy for ages. So, right now our pollution output should be really good. Yeah, it's manageable. I mean, iron is still low because we are not using that much iron plates. But especially this sector up here and up here, which previously had a very high amount of pollution, now is back to zero because we are currently not using any boilers or whatsoever to create energy. When it gets nighttime, I want to take a look at it and see the difference, but you can actually see that our pollution cloud now is way smaller. It was here last time and now it's almost vanished as far as I'm concerned. Steel producing. Let's see, we'll need some steel today. 70 steel per minute. That's alright. I can live with that. Yeah, and as you know, we need more cracked oil. I thought of this pun to be very funny. Sorry if it wasn't funny. Oh yeah, and we have to connect these guys back to our energy system. I want to work with logic networks to automatically have them run if there is a power shortage. So we'll do that later. I just want to see how power production is changing in the night. Let's connect with our actual main power system. So now they are running. Okay, so solar energy goes down. Energy from steam engine goes up. And you can also hear how the steam engines are. Oh, whoops, missing a power pole there. How the steam engines are moving faster and faster. Okay. So we are now producing around 4 megawatt of energy. And let's check back with pollution. And we are already back at 1.3. I want to take a look at it. What the max value of it is. And as you can see, the pollution of this sector is also real high. That's because if the pollution is in this sector is high, it pours back in this sector, and this sector puts pollution out in this sector as well, and they are together, they are producing so much pollution that it pours back into the sector. So, yeah. Alright, so we will hook that up later. These are not connected. Our carbon production. So, deducing from the intro, we need more cracked oil. Because I need some sulfur to make batteries And when I'm done making batteries, I want to get rid of oil and oil cracking altogether in my base and start using trains. Because I think trains are cool. So that's my goal for today. We are already 5 minutes in. So I'm positive we won't make it, but we can try. So I need some tanks just for now, some storage tanks. 1 and 2 and 3. One for light oil, one for heavy oil, and one for petroleum gas. Which sounds about right. We're fairly good with iron plates. Let me check if I have a... RF. I have an arithmetic combinator, but not a transformer. Nope, not yet. Alright, so I cannot switch off my power. Okay, we're at the energy producing sector and we are back to zero. Well, not quite zero. It's 500, but 500 is... I'm okay with 500. So, solar energy really helps. Can we check? Yeah, you see. And to smooth out these spikes, I want to get batteries and therefore accumulators, so we can save some energy, which we then can use during the night. And then our steam engines will be a mere backup plan. So I sever the connection. These are like being a subnetwork. So I guess I just stop electric power altogether and take my burner inserters and change them. Oops, one too much. Alright, so now the burner inserters will put coal in themselves and basically that's it. And they are not using up anything unless they are moving, so now this is not using any power whatsoever, because in before we had electric inserters who have like still an energy requirement even if they are not moving, so these four steam machines would still be running even if it was slow. So yeah, okay, I'm piping in gas directly into this chemical plant, which made a nice amount of sulfur for me. But I want to intervene a little bit. There's oil coming out. Alright, I guess I can manage. Now we are cracking just because we have to fill these pipes, which is nice. Okay, let's see. Okay, it goes underground and comes back up. So goes underground. Ah, this isn't possible, as it seems. So you would need different pipes. So this is heavy oil. How much space do I have? Let's just put our tank here. Yeah, this now has heavy oil. Alright, now we have to... use a different type of underground pipe, I guess. So the size is 10. The under... and this... oh, stone pipes is actually a larger size. We are producing equal amounts of oil, alright. Well then, I'll go with stone pipes. So I guess this is a... it's still working. So what's with this? Can you do something else? Yeah, you can. Huh. But these two outputs are not in use right now. Let me think about it. So, okay. Well, then we can use steel pipes as well for this. Whoops. Alright. I don't know if this has any occurrence in the production of sulfur, but I think not. Of course, machines are actually smart in this game. But pipes are not. Okay. Another tank. These are quite big. Also, this is just a temporary solution, since I want to outsource oil mining. Yeah, oil mining and oil cracking. Okay, and petroleum gas. Just... goes underground. Let's do it like so. All right. And now this is in parallel. And now we make a little curve. Like so. Underground. Away into a tank. Just so we can keep up our production, sorry. Okay, need another piece of pipe. Okay, now we should be constantly cracking oil. As far as I'm concerned. Yes, nice. Okay. Producing sulfur, let's just set up a steel chest for now. Nice, alright. Okay. Oh, there's a power switch. So I can separate this network. Alright, but I will do it off camera. There's also a valve. Nice. Okay. Let's see. For a high capacity accumulator, we need 10 batteries and 3 iron plates. So let's see. Intermediate products. Batteries. We'll need lead plates, plastic bar, and sulfuric acid. And to make sulfuric acid, we need another chemical plant. Let's put it right next to this one. Sulfuric acid is made out of sulfur, I hope. We'll see. There were two recipes. Okay, there's only one. So we need sulfur dioxide and water. Water is no problem. So you will make sulfur dioxide. And where do you get the oxygen from? Water electrolysis. Made an electrolyzers. Wow, alright. Pooh, it's getting cramped in here. Okay, so there's our electrolyzer. Of course it needs power. So you please do water electrolysis, and you just need pure water. And pure water is being made from normal water. Okay, so we need another chemical plant. Alright, so you guys, you are doing pure water from normal water. So you have a water input. Ah, it's getting night time. This actually is quite fast. Okay, and from pure water, you directly hooked up, which is nice, can then produce this stuff. And now you can make sulfur dioxide. Okay, so we need a transportation belt from this guy. And another inserter, which gets the sulfur. I like watching the charts and the graphs of this game. It's so relaxing. Okay, and you are producing sulfur dioxide. And we need another chemical plant again. I never played with gases that much in original Factorio. I never got to the moment in time where you can build a rocket. Okay, and you will do sulfuric acid. What? Oh, you can do it with iron plates and water. No. I want water and sulfur dioxide. Because this seems easier to do than actually getting iron plates over here. Okay. I guess I have to put this one tile to the left. Like so. Alright. Now we can have pipes. Sulfuric acid. Wow. Yet again. So this would make more sense, right? Can I not hook up? Who invented these? So, what if I just hook this one up? Okay, it's not counting. So now I have to make underground pipes just because of that. Okay. What? I have to leave some room. Of course, water will come through an underground pipe. I've locked myself in, probably. But I don't care. Alright. Yeah. Like this? Oh, this is not good. Now these are full with water. Okay. Again. Underground pipe. Then you'll go in here. Okay. Oh, you need more oxygen. And why is there no oxygen? Because the hydrogen is not being piped out. So I have to place... Okay, everything. Everything has to go. Sorry. I'm learning. Okay. So, one tile apart. Let's say two piles. For good measure. Alright. So, inserter. And then hydrogen goes. Good thing, or at least I can imagine it's a good thing, with gases and byproduct from these, a gas handling is that you have all the gases available that you need, because they are being produced somewhere else as byproducts. Alright, now we've got the hydrogen tank. Okay. Again. You're all sulfur dioxide guy. And you only need oxygen. So, there you go. Okay. I thought it would be nice to get the gases to be double output or double input, but I guess the game doesn't care because gases are flowing fast enough. Okay. We need electrical power again. Okay. So this is the water coming in. How much pollution do you... 1.8, it's actually not that much. Okay. Then I'll go three tiles apart for good measure. This is one tile apart, this is two tiles, this is three tiles, alright. So, water... Like so. So, here we have sulfuric acid. Water. Here, and you output sulfur dioxide to the ground. Like so. Connected here. Okay. You got your stuff. Just need power. Now we got sulfuric acid. I can't take it into my hands, obviously. Okay, so batteries, sulfuric acid, plastic bar and lead plate, so... And how are they made? In a chemical plant. Okay, so I guess I build the next chemical plant. Up here. I definitely have to outsource stuff. So I'm going to make new weapons and armor-piercing ammunition and get rid of some aliens up here. Where the whole crude oil is, I'll... And there is lead. I could make a battery production up there. Yeah. But we'll see. Okay. Now. We're outputting petroleum gas, actually. Now we're inputting it. I'm confused. Where does the gas go? In here. Huh. So are we cracking oil or what? I guess. Yeah. Okay. So another chemical plant it is. And also a power switch. I guess 20 minutes. How fast time is flying. Okay, next chemical plant. Hello there. Batteries, please. Sulfuric acid. Why are you not pulling in stuff? Did I do something wrong? Or do you need both ports to be piped into? Yeah, seems like. Let's try that out. Okay, plastic bars and lead plate. Do I have lead plates? Yes. And how are plastic bars made? Not by hand, but with petroleum gas and coal in chemical plants. Dude. Okay, we have coal here and we have petroleum gas here. I thought they are made of silicone or something like that. But it's actually nice. Okay. I bet I'm shoveling my own grave here by deleting that much trees. But I really want to make these accumulators. Okay, we made the chemical plants, so again... Please, plastic bar. The transport belts. We've got them here. Nice curve. Alright. And the gas. Let's make an underground pipe. Since we got them, we can use them. Alright. You're filling in. Nice. And the inserter would be nice, I guess. And of course, electric power. And there is the plastic going. So what happens if I split the gas up, like so? Oh, we are not producing enough petroleum gas, I guess. to keep production running. But it's not that bad. Okay, so there you go. Take some plastic, please. And give me batteries. One battery. Okay. So let's do some math here. Simple math. Quick maths! Iron plates and 10 batteries. And we get 600 kilowatt. So we need one accumulator for 6 solar panels. How much solar panels do I have? These are 21. Okay, so for every 2 rows I need I need 7 accumulators. So 7 and 7 makes 14. And then like 18 plus 3. So another 2. So 16 accumulators makes 16 by 10 makes 160 batteries, and this makes 160 plastic bars. All right. Alright, so after double checking, we have to indeed to produce 160 plastic bars. Why are you not putting in coal? I bet it's because you don't have any energy. Who knows? Or we need to put out these plastic bars into a chest. Everything is possible. Yep. There we go. Alright. So only 150 more to go. I guess. How much sulfur do we need? Or sulfuric acid? 40 per. Is it 40? 20. 20 per. Oh, and we need more lead plates, but I can get that. Alright. So let's go to our lead factory. There we are. And I did not set up a chest, as I can see. So I'll do that now. Chest. Little guy. Energy. Go. I want to make a stack inserter. Ooh. But as I see, we need transistors. So these are not resistors, these are basic electric components, but these are transistors indeed. God damn. So I guess this will be our next big technological jump. I guess. Okay, we need 320 lead plates. So I'll come up with a daylight sensor design off camera and we'll just do it next episode. Almost forgot to take in my lead plates. Okay. Back to the... Back to the petroleum factory, I guess. So we are still producing plastic like mad, and we are almost done with it. That's good. Oh, it cannot take more than 212 plates. Okay, fine by me. So now we just have to wait for our plastic parts. And we actually got them. Okay. In there. And we are producing batteries like mad. Okay, I'm back, and in the meantime I came up with a daylight sensor. Circuit plan. So I started cooking up some accumulators, and now I'll have them like between my solar panels, like so. All right. So they are charging. So what I want to know is, does this count as consuming energy? I guess. All right, but in general, I'll have here the accumulators. And as long as they are not empty, I want to have the steam engines to be shut down. So I have to build a control accumulator, or use one of them to read its power level from it. So let's get on with them. Yeah, we are still missing a few batteries, but that's not a problem. Wait for another one. Okay, now we are at 16 accumulators, which is exactly... Oh, we are only at 15. Never mind. But it's almost as much as we wanted. So I'll plunk them down right here in the middle between these solar panels. So they practically will all charge at the same time. I think that's a good idea. Let's see, normal electric wire should be in. Hello. Can you please place yourself down? Right. Ooh, this is getting messy. All right. So from all the way down. It probably won't even go all the way down. So where exactly are my steam engines? There. Yeah, so I'll put these accumulators upwards. You can go away. You can go away. Right. Damn it. Alright, so now I have to use the power switch. Like so. And then basically I have to make sure that every accumulator is part of the network, so they are all in parallel. Okay, so they are all full, so I guess they are all in parallel. What's up with energy production? Solar cells are still producing. Alright, and steam engines are coming up. Okay. So right now, no accumulator gets drained. So I want to read the power level? Right? So, recharge level. Recharge level is the percentage between 0 and 100 and sends it to the circuit network as output signal A. Okay. And where can I get the signal A? There. Signal A. If signal A is equal to 0, then the switch will turn on. So, how can I check that? That's a good question. Let's sever this. This is complicated. Well, let's establish the connection first. So, you are going here, and we need a manual wire to this power pole, and then we can use its large wire reach to actually go and connect only with the steam engines. So right. Oh, shit. I severed the connection to both sides. Okay. And I need another power pole, a large one. You will go in between these steam engines. Yes? Alright, severed all the connections. Now again, we use copper wire. Oh! We are not in range. This is sad. I don't need this power pole. So, small one. Has to go. Wire goes here. And then from this large power pole, we go to this smaller one. Or let's just use the medium one. Okay. So now these steam engines are not hooked up. So upcoming night we should be using our accumulator energy. So we'll see. So I'll be back as soon as it's night. See you in a bit. All right, it's night time and our accumulators are sizzling like hell, and they're dropping quite fast in energy. I hooked up the signal number A to electrical poles, so now I can read it off. So down there you got the charge rate of the accumulators, which right now is 60%. And as soon I want to have this lamp on, as soon as the signal strength of A is lower than 50, right? Now this lamp is on, and it consumes energy from this network, which is the steam engine. But these 5 kilowatt are not a problem. Oh! And we got through the night. Alright. Let me reload that then. Okay, back to before the night. And let's get rid of some accumulators. Now that energy level should drop faster, since this was the only accumulator. And boom, energy level is zero, switch is closed, and our steam engines are taking up production. Alright. Now I just have to connect my old network to the new network. So yeah, I think it's wrapping up point. We made some accumulators and finally got our energy to be stored and get us through the night. So no more coal burning, only in severe cases of energy loss or something like that. So next episode we'll make MRPCing bullets and get rid of some of the aliens and start making outposts and get trains. So yeah, I hope you learned something. I definitely did. See you in the next episode. Bye bye. Thank you for watching.